Hello and welcome to the third part of my LEGO Powered Up programming tutorial. Today we want to put the idea with the train a bit further. In the last part we moved the motor for 1 second. And now my idea is that we have two train stations and the train should move from one station to the next and then again to the first and so on. Both are in a circle. So they are in the same distance to each other. So the train has to drive for a given amount. And first of all, I will change this power control block to a speed control block because that's more precise. Keep in mind that normal train motors don't have a speed control option, but I use the Crocodile that uses a Control Plus motor. And so this works. But the normal train motor doesn't have a speed control. I did a bit of preparation for this video and the train has to drive for around about 5.5 seconds in order to get to the next station. We can already test the program. So I will start the program. And it drove roundabout to the next station. You will have to adjust this delay on your own if you make a program that does what this does. Keep in mind that it's also relative to the speed. The delay only works for one speed. And you must be very precise if you want it to move for more than three loops, because it will always drive a bit too much or not long enough. And then it won't get in front of the station. We will fix that problem in the next part, but for this part, I want to optimize this program a bit. First of all, I want to add a few sounds. You will probably not hear them good because of my setup, but they will be played and you can hear them if you do this program on your own. The app has pre-made sounds for the whistle, or for whistle, for train, and for a few other things. So I will put one sound in front. This will be a starting sound for the train. And then I will put a brake after it stops. So basically, now it makes a starting sound before it starts to drive, then it drives until it's in front of the next station, then it stops, and then it makes a brake sound. But it would be fun if the train would drive from one station to the next one and would do that all over again, and again and again. So we will use a new block, the loop block. This block repeats everything that's inside of the loop. And there are no limits on how many blocks can be put inside of the loop. Only the stuff inside of the loop gets executed again and again. So if I put everything here, then we will start the program. It will go into the loop and it will keep in mind, hey, my loop starts here. Then it will play the sound, drive forwards until it gets to the station, plays the other sound, realizes, oh, I'm at the end of the loop, so I will go back to the beginning of the loop and I will start all over. And it will run like this again and again. And there is no limit for this loop because this is an infinite loop. So it will run basically until the batteries are dead. We can try this, but I can already spoil to you that it won't work exactly like we want, because we want that passengers can move inside and outside of the train. And before we had the loop, the program simply stopped at the next station. But this time it starts again and there is no time for the passengers to get into the train and go out of the train between the break and the start. So we will have to put another wait block behind the last block. You can say how long it should stay in the station with this delay. So I think that 1 second is good enough. And let's try it. It makes the starting sound, then it starts to drive after the sound is finished. For 5.5 seconds, it stops and makes the brake sound. Passengers can go in and out, and it makes the starting sound again, and then it starts to drive. And it will do this again and again until the batteries are dead. So this works how we want it. That's great. You may want to put the first starting sound behind the starting motor block and then adjust the delay in regards to that, because now it basically starts the motor and only starts to drive after the sound has finished. But I will leave that up to you. However, there's still a problem. I will stop the program. Let's say that there is an interruption or something on the line, and that the train maybe gets stopped by a hand or something for 1 second. Then it won't know where it is and it will not get to the station. Or let's say there's something else. There can be many reasons why the loop gets interrupted. Maybe you didn't calculate the right times and then it moves too far or not far enough. And we will fix that in the next part. And for that, we will require a sensor. I will mainly stick to the color and distance sensor from the LEGO Boost set. You can plug that into the normal hubs as well. And I really like the sensor. It's pretty cheap and you can make many, many things with that. So I would suggest that you buy it if you don't have it already. I will use it in the next part, but of course you don't have to buy it. You can follow the video along. Maybe you have a similar sensor that you can use, or you don't have one and just watch it. Do you have another idea for models that can use this type of program that moves for a given amount of time, then waits for a given amount of time, and then moves again? Maybe you come up with an idea. I only came up with a train, but you might be more creative than me. Please write it into the comments and make sure that you adjust the programs, that you test stuff, and that you actually learn stuff and don't just watch my tutorial. You can also try to adjust the program so that it drives from station to station without waiting for my tutorial, and then you can compare your solution to my solution. Anyways, that was it for this part. Thanks for watching. Feel free to ask me any questions that come up in the comments. See you in the next video and bye bye.